the next big thing. Last week I played Evil Land up to the final boss, and just didn't have time to finish it in the stream time that I had. So I did actually go back and finish the boss off stream and recorded that there and put it up on my YouTube channel. So if you do want to, if you were watching that and you want to see the end of it, you can go back and watch that there on the YouTube. So this is the next big thing. This is a point-and-click adventure, kind of 1930s Hollywood, tough guys, tough dames, investigating in Hollywood and the whole movie scene. So this should be kind of fun. As a note going on, I am not going to be streaming Friday or Sunday this week because I'll be going away to a librarian conference. Yes, this is as exciting as it sounds. So I will not be available to do that there. Next Tuesday, I will be back for another Quirky Tuesday, but I will be going on this coming weekend, which unfortunately, because I'm at the conference, I won't be able to do, is the International Game Jam. So I hope anybody who's interested in there checks it out and takes a look at it. I will be, I think what I'm going to do next Tuesday is I'm going to go find a whole bunch of games made during the International Game Jam, and I'll play those throughout the night. And then following Tuesday, I'll come back to the next big thing and hopefully finish it or get further in there. So that's the plan. So now let's get into the game here and see what's happening. I kind of came in here before just to make sure that it recorded and streamed okay. Had to play around with the resolution a bit, but I kind of deleted anything that I did before. So I am completely new to this. I don't know how it's going to go. So let's get started. New player. I did like this guy, this knight guy. Is this one or this one? I'm going to go with this one here. Check out the warning. We'll go with this one here. Okay, I will type my name. My name is Frank. Enter a password. I don't want a password. No need for that there. Okay, so... Oh, there I am. It's a difficulty. Let's see. Low hotspots and help on. Medium. Hotspots on, help off. Hard or high, hotspots and help off. Let's keep the hotspots on. Let's see how it goes with that there. I can always make it more difficult or make it easier if I need to. Whatever, we don't know. So, it does. Okay. And see how this goes.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we begin, you should know that the story you're about to hear has quite a number of,
Come on, spit it out.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
Zoom in on the eye. It's a fish. The man looking at a fish. It's a man on a gurney. Well.
Murray!
It's Fly! Oh, one of my favorite moves. There are a lot of fish. Nope, didn't work. Aw, poor little fly guy. Aw.
The pizza has arrived.
Pizza. Hungry people. I like how there's one piece of pepperoni on every single slice.
Oh, he's alive. And he's hungry.
Needs tomato sauce.
Wait a minute. The story doesn't start that way. Ah, yes. Ladies and gentlemen.
Big. Ayo,
let's begin at the beginning.
It's a good place to start. Anything. Okay, so this is from the same people that made a game called Runaway, which I haven't played yet. If I really like this, it might be something I might look out and seek there. That next big thing. And apparently this has also been recently released on... recently released on iOS under a game called Hollywood, under the name Hollywood Monsters. Golden Death Chickens?
What did you just say?
Didn't you hear me?
Of course I heard you.
Good for you.
I'm not deaf.
Right, just dumb.
You jerk.
He's a jerk. Lunatic. He's a jerk.
Dan Murray, the boss has assigned this story to the two of us. If you don't come into the theater with me and do your part...
So, you don't think you can do it alone?
I think I'm more than capable.
You don't say.
Dan Murray, I'm going to go into that theater and write a Pulitzer Prize story by myself. You hear me?
You're gonna leave me out here in the cold in the dead of autumn?
I hope you freeze.
Hmm, how can I keep myself warm?
Really, did he just say that?
Dan, it was fabulous. I did so many interviews that we're gonna have to ask the boss for more space. Fitz Randolph, Professor Fly, Chrome Ha, Eva Morte, the poet, the Grim Reaper, and the short guy from Monster Without a Cause.
Fascinating.
Yeah, you know, the one from, hey, what's that?
It's antifreeze.
Dan Murray, have you been out here drinking while I was in there doing your job? That's it. The byline is going to be mine and mine alone. They can fire you for all I care. What's more, if they ask me for a shovel to help dig your grave, I'll be more than happy to help. And if...
Hey, what's he up to?
Big Albert. In Fitz Randall's office. That's odd.
You were saying?
We have to go in there.
My thoughts exactly.
Finally, real investigative journalism. Come on, move it.
He's got spunk.
Sweetheart. My thing is sports writing. If he hits you with a baseball bat, call me.
Sweetheart.
And that's how it all started for Liz Allaire. She decided she was going into that office with or without Dan's help.
Okay. That's Dan. That's a light. Pretty sky. Okay. Good. Let's see. Let's look at Dan.
Jerk.
I mean,
jerk.
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 Jerk. Jerk.
Okay, we'll stop with that. Let's look at the hood.
Once got my head caught under the hood of my father's car. Anne Marie, my smart sister, was being Tarzan. Queenie, my pretty sister, was Jane. I was Cheetah, and the car was the crocodile.
Apparently I tried to eat her. Okay, so we go... Imagine. Well, that's an interesting architect. I can look at the theater. Let's see.
It's enormous, but it was completely full for the ceremony.
Sorry if I'm kind of munching at the banger. Couch.
Tabby the Third, Fitz Randolph's pet, is inside.
That might be useful to know. Palm tree. There's a robot.
He has a saw for a hand. How uncomfortable.
She is very, very observant about things like this, isn't she? Sorry, I really shouldn't be eating. Let's, anything else I can look at? There's a car, there's a theater. Guess we go inside the mansion. There are robots in here.
Hiyo, miss. I thought you were going.
Mr. Fitz Randolph.
Now, come and sit beside me, Miss Allaire. I never imagined you were such a party girl.
Me? No. I'm still here because it's so pleasant here, don't you think?
You don't need an excuse, miss. My friend Murray's intern is always welcome.
Oh.
Actually, I was referring to your unusual style of dancing.
Oh, I see.
Have I offended you?
Yes. No. Maybe. It's just that...
Okay, let's see. I'm nobody's intern. What about my style of dancing? I'm going to take a walk. Let's see. I'm kind of curious. Why is he sitting here by himself?
How is it that you're sitting here by yourself?
I love parties, but when you get to be my age...
Well, how old are you,
Since
Mr.
I'm
Fitz
the host,
Randolph?
I can't go to bed. But at least here it's quiet.
I get that.
In our interview earlier, I forgot to ask you.
Oh, jeez. You have a lot of questions to ask. She's a very nosy lady. Okay, so we could spill the beans right here. Your super productions. Let's see. Okay, so let me read these out here. Do you get along with the stars of your super productions? Big Albert has gotten into your office. How is business going? Support your answer. Like, write your essay. Complete sentences only. Donations, foundations, charity events. Do you have any time left for yourself? Would you like to go on a date with a young reporter? Horror movies have allowed monsters to gain acceptance in society. Are you proud of that? Thank you for your time. Let's go with the flirtation.
Donations, foundations, charity events. Do you have any time left for yourself?
I'm just doing my part for the less fortunate, miss. Without the little people below.
The little cream people. Of society would sink to the bottom.
How did you know I was going to say that?
I didn't.
Disconcerting.
Do you get along with the stars of your super productions?
Well, I try to be a good employer, but it's not always easy. Fame goes to their heads. They do strange things.
Support your answer.
How's business going? Support your answer.
MKO is still the largest movie studio in the country and the world. We have made horror movies fashionable. And as long as that continues, nothing can touch us.
I do appreciate that she's actually saying the exact lines that are choices here. Sometimes it's kind of frustrating when you have conversation choices and they say something completely off the wall. Okay. Let's talk about
horror movies have allowed monsters to gain acceptance in society. Are you proud of that?
Not completely accepted, miss. It's true that we aren't persecuted anymore and that we finally have the same rights as everybody else, but unfortunately, there are still many minds to change. So many people judge other people by their appearance.
So essentially the premise of this game, part of the game here and such, is that in the monster movies, the monsters are played by actual monsters, as themselves. We see what happens when I say Big Albert? Let's see.
Big Albert has...
Yes?
Yes, what?
Big Albert, what about him?
Is he feeling all right?
Miss, if this keeps up, I will end up understanding why they call you Loony Liz.
Thank you for your time.
Loony Liz? I'm Loony. What about my
style of dancing?
Well, you're not accustomed to dancing in public.
But I look quite good in the mirror. Are you insinuating that I'm not a good dancer? Vegetable soup. Now, where are we? I really want to say the vegetable soup line. I don't understand the context of it. Yeah, let's do it. Vegetable soup.
I don't understand. Do you want
I
some?
I don't understand what? Either.
Vegetable soup.
Ah, huh, what's in it?
Disconcerting.
You keep using that word. I don't think it means what you think it means. I've never... Should we go insulted? Yeah.
Are you insinuating that I'm not a good dancer?
No, although society may not be prepared to see a woman move so many parts of her body so rapidly and with so much independence with respect to the rhythm.
Aha! I'm a feminist.
She's a bad dancer. But she's also a feminist.
I've never danced in public, but I look quite good in the mirror.
Then don't let anyone tell you otherwise.
Dance like nobody's watching.
If I had believed myself when I was young, I wouldn't be where I am today.
Now, where were we?
I'm nobody's intern. Just like in Mass Effect, I'm a Spectre. Or Batman. I'm Batman.
I'm nobody's intern.
Oh, pardon me. It's just that you're so young, and Murray is so... So, you know what I mean. So Murray.
Dan's a jerk. Yeah.
Dan's a jerk.
You are very hard on him, and I think I know why. Do you find him attractive?
But how dare you? Do you know that I once knocked over a refrigerator with my head? Do you think you're better than a refrigerator?
Poor
and it was
head.
Full at the time.
She had
20, 12, 1, 4. It really is very pleasant here, isn't it?
Can't even count straight. Okay, so I wonder why, because her poor head, she got it stuck in the car hood. and she knocked over a refrigerator with it. This poor lady.
Stan is a sports writer. How do you know him?
I'll only say one thing. The Los Angeles Freaks. I'm the owner.
How nice.
The baseball team, miss. I bought it years ago, and Murray comes to all the games.
I just hope you like him. He's a jerk.
Why does everyone like Dan?
I don't want to seem arrogant, but Murray is like me. We're both self-made men, and we both have kept our common touch.
Dan's not worth talking about so much. I'm gonna take a walk.
Just one thing, miss. As you're probably already aware, I know some of the best doctors in the country, including psychiatrists.
I have a cousin who's a veterinarian.
I've observed that you sometimes say disconcerting things.
Why does he always pause in the middle of that word?
Yes, of course. It's, take the vegetable soup, for example.
Poor thing. Haven't you had dinner?
Yes. No, I won't keep you any longer.
Okay, I hope I get to play the entire game as her.
Cons, I can't go into the hall that leads to Fitz Randolph's office while he's right there next to it. Pros, he gets along with Dan. This is the idea.
Bad idea.
Good.
Bad.
Jerk.
Lunatic.
Dan Murray, are you telling me that you do not intend to go into the mansion or to get Fitz Randolph away from the hall?
In a nutshell.
Well, okay then.
Okay.
Good.
Good.
But Liz Allaire was not a woman to give up easily, and she decided to convince Dan to get Fitz Randolph away from the hall.
Okay, how is she going to do that?
I'll get him to take Fitz Randolph away from the hall, by golly.
By golly! It must be more fun.
Once got my head caught under the hood of my father's car.
It'd be more fun if she had a British
Anne-Marie,
accent.
Anne-Marie, my smart sister, was being Tarzan. Queenie, my pretty sister,
right,
was Jane.
Saw this already.
I was Cheetah, and the car was the crocodile.
The titles don't exactly match the words. Okay. So I guess we go back to the mansion here. Let's see. The dog?
Tubby the Third, Fitz Randolph's pet, is inside.
Tubby.
A ray of sunshine.
What?
He's happy in his own way.
What else did she say about the
a
robot?
A ray of sunshine.
So marvelous. Oh, there's a window. I can look at the window.
This connects to Fitz Randolph's office, where Big Albert went in.
That apparently does not help at all.
Nobody's in there now. The few remaining guests are at the party.
Okay, so I guess let's go to the mansion.
It's one of Dr. Zelsius's revolutionary robots.
Put him up!
Oh, he's seen better days.
You're so judgmental. I'm good.
Nice glasses.
When it comes to pumpkins. I guess I should have saved this for on Halloween. Bob.
Oh, he's seen better days.
Okay, I'm not looking at you.
He's seen better days.
It's a corridor.
That's where the ball is, but it's dying down now. When I left, only Death, Octopus Herring, the Chupacabras, and some others were left.
Can we go meet Death? Let's go see what goes up here. I know this is probably not the way to go.
Is everything all right, miss?
Hey. They're all kind of the same.
I'm gonna take a walk.
Enjoy yourself.
I'm not going to get anything new there, but we can go check out the corridor. Okay, wow.
Miss Allaire, could you confirm that the reading room is being remodeled? Confirmed. Thank you. You're welcome. My pleasure.
She is fun. Okay, so what's coming down? There's a sword up there. Oops. Archer.
Books. Wonderful childhood companions. Nice painting. Large cans of white paint and little ones with blue pigment.
Okay. Look at the vest.
Did the workers leave this behind?
Okay, what about
especially this recommended for climbing to nowhere.
Yep.
Looks like they want to paint the room blue. I hope they're not going for an overly intense blue. I hope they're not going for an overly intense blue.
Anything else to click in here?
Nice painting. What a place to leave books! How little respect people have for culture!
I'm a librarian, I think that's actually fine.
Wonderful childhood companions.
Don't worry about it. Okay, nothing I can do there. Do the best of you. Can I do something? Ah! Take the vest.
If there was anything in the pocket, someone got here before me and took it.
Ah, so I need to right-click on things. Can I right-click? Oh.
I could take a book.
Okay, I need to right-click on things.
I don't have any more room at home. I'd have to buy another refrigerator.
Wait, what's that?
If I sit here and start to read a book, I won't be able to put it down until morning.
Let's see what we can do with the painting.
I'm not gonna take the painting that's sitting there.
I could take some blue paint.
The cans of pigment weigh less.
Okay, so we're not gonna take the white paint.
I don't need more pigment or any paint.
Okay.
I'm not going up, nor am I moving it.
Okay. I'm getting the hang of this now. Okay, so can I get to my... I get that. Yeah. Wow. That really does seem to be kind of like cheating, doesn't it? Okay, convince Dan. Okay. I get it. And this then goes to the next part of the story. Aha. Okay, so I need to convince Dan. Okay. Let's see what else we have. No, I don't help. See, it's blanked out. I'm getting the hang of this now. Control panel. Okay. Music. Credits. Save game. Introduce a description. Okay. Twitch. 01. Load a game. Can delete a game. There I am. Subtitles on. That's good. Statistics. Oh, I see. Do I have like a limited amount of times I can turn on? Okay. Game. Okay. Oh, so far, I don't have needed to use the hotspots very much. Something with a pumpkin. The robots are dancing. It's kind of cute.
These could be Professor Flies.
Okay, let's see.
This doesn't need pigment.
Ah, okay, right here. Tape recorder.
This isn't going to get me any interesting headlines, no matter how much I record. Without this, I wouldn't have gotten into the award ceremony or the party. Only 5 minutes left in its memory. It would be good if I could get Big Albert to confess. If there was anything in the pocket, someone got here before me and took it. Blue. I don't really see it working in the reading room.
Reference 569. Might be useful.
Prose, they help you see. Cons, seeing everything in red is nerve-wracking.
They are pretty slick goggles, though. Hey. I could talk to the robot. It's cute.
So, short stuff, you guarding the stairs?
Restricted area. Only person authorized, William A. Fitzrandolph.
Don't worry, I'm not trying to go up.
Yet. I have good manners because I went to finishing school. How about you?
I have good manners because I went to finishing school. How about you?
Negative.
It's Randolph's private quarters are up there, right?
Restricted area.
What happens if I go up the stairs?
I punch you.
Well, it's been a pleasure. See you later.
Negative.
Negative. Hey, can I talk to you? Get a gorilla. Oh, you're gorillas now.
Ayo, short stuff. I don't have anything against your brother over there, but I bet you're the nice one in the family, aren't you?
Restricted area. Only person authorized, William A. Fitzrandolph.
I see.
They're kind of single-minded, aren't they?
Good manners because I went to finishing school. How about you?
Negative.
Fill in the blanks.
Fill in the blanks.
Dan Murray was so dumb that in school he
got one
negative
after another, but he managed to get a job. And one day he touched a co-worker's
restricted area.
And she, who was as clever as she was a good dancer, said to him,
"I punch you."
Well, it's been a pleasure. See you later.
Negative.
That was incredible. That was so much fun.
Hey, yo, short stuff.
Let's see. Is there any possibility you could be a little more open to negotiation?
Negative.
Oh, come on. I like the flirtatiousness.
I would just love to get inside your head to find out what you're thinking.
Restricted area.
He sure has a restricted area.
Is there any possibility you could be a little more open to negotiation?
Negative.
What happens if I go up the stairs?
I punch you.
Well, it's been a pleasure. See you later.
Negative.
After the way they all laughed when I started dancing, I prefer not to go in.
Aw, poor Liz. Oh. There's a reading room, and there's a corridor. Oh, the corridor. Seats. Okay. I'm finding more things to click on. Ooh.
Heyo, Edgar. What are you doing at the window?
Heyo. Weren't you going?
Oh, hey-o. Sometimes I'm going, and sometimes I'm coming. What are you doing at the window?
Shall I take your jacket again?
I'm gonna be coming and going. What are you doing at the window?
Rehearsing.
Ah, you've been cast in a movie?
No, just rehearsing for the sake of rehearsing.
Aww, Edgar.
With my looks, nobody can believe I'd be competent as a monster in front of the camera.
Out of work actor. Coat check attendant. Obvious synergies.
That's it. They don't let you play monsters?
They don't let you play monsters?
No. With my looks, I don't scare anyone. At the auditions, I don't even get to act. They send me packing as soon as they lay eyes on me.
Let's see.
How long have you been working for Fitzrandolph?
About a month. He pays well, and he's nice.
What type of work are you doing right now?
A little of everything. Maintenance, basically. I do whatever needs doing.
And Fitzrandolph can't give you a recommendation?
No, that would compromise his integrity. He gives his producers and directors complete artistic freedom and never interferes in things like casting.
Was your appearance this original when you were a boy?
Yes, from day one. I was born in a beautiful.
The artwork of this game is beautiful.
Absolutely ordinary place. With your typical farm animals.
I did chicken.
Why did I turn out peculiar?
Why then?
Your guess is as good as mine.
I wonder
things
why.
Of Mother Nature.
Enough said. Let's move on.
There's a book. I like books.
I like books. Who does the one on the table belong
to? Wait, she says that. I like books.
For autographs, I've gotten them from all the celebrities at the party. Except for Hammer Boy Brown.
Okay. There's a little tidbit to kind of keep in mind.
20, 12, 1, 4.
I don't understand. Why did you say that?
To help myself relax. It works every time. Go on, rehearse. I'll watch you.
I'm on it.
So now he's into rehearsing. Poor thing.
Okay.
Edgar's autograph book.
I can take
it. Edgar's. And I don't steal.
Usually. And Edgar.
Is he talking to himself?
Rehearsing. We just went over this.
It's Blue Harrelson, the star of Vulcan Flash in the Attack of the Killer Tomatoes, who disappeared without a... Wait a minute. Edgar! You are Vulcan Flash.
I wish.
Seriously, you could pass for him. Now you have a job.
Blue paint
strange
and the goggles.
Eyes, dressed like this. Impossible. I'm very grateful to you, but no.
Maybe it was out of generosity or stubbornness, or just because she happened to feel like it. But Liz decided that very night she would convince Edgar of his future as Vulcan Flash. For that, her original mind came up with a mental image that she decided to call the Complete Alien Kit, which she would equip with everything required for this altruistic goal.
Complete Alien Kit.
Of course, he looks like Edgar. That's fine where it is.
Yes. Let's go here.
Yes. The effect is positively alien.
Okay. That there.
On second thought, the color blue is a fundamental characteristic of the Great Vulcan Flash. Agreed. He's not exactly the guy in the poster, but close enough. If I'm not mistaken, my complete alien kit is ready
for
action.
This is what happens for being nosy before I...
Can you confirm that for me, Miss Allaire? Confirmed. The alien kit is complete.
She talks to herself. It's so wonderful.
There's my Edgar. Hammerboy Brown. Brief profile.
No way. You don't know who Manny Hammerboy Brown is? The world flyweight champion.
Flyweight? Sounds good. What is this? What luck?
Boxing.
Oh, poor thing.
See my jacket? Well, it's his. Was his. He left it here when he went into the party. And I said to him, hey, Manny, how about that autograph? And he comes back with... Get lost, elf. A little while later, he left drunk with a girl and forgot his jacket. And that is the last he ever saw of it.
The Making of the New Vulcan Flash. Story by Liz Allaire. I repeat, you could be the new Vulcan Flash.
No, Liz, I don't even look like an Earth monster, which is what I am.
Whatever happened to Blue Harrelson, the original Vulcan?
No one knows. They rented a spaceship for a Vulcan Flash in the Attack of the Killer Tomatoes sequence. Blue Harrelson got into it, and he didn't come out. He disappeared. By the next day, the spaceship was gone too. And the assistant director couldn't even remember where he rented it.
Your problem is that you aren't scary. But Vulcan doesn't have to be.
Look at me through the eyes of a producer. He has blue skin, strange eyes, that vest, and I don't.
Through the eyes of a producer, meaning with no imagination?
Exactly.
Fine, but you haven't convinced me. Let's drop it for the moment.
Okay, so...
Go on, rehearse. I'll watch you.
I'm on it.
Let's see, can I take an item from here? Ah, here we go.
Finally, the moment has arrived for opening the refrigerator. There's my Edgar.
Okay.
You talking to me?
I am going to put an end to your sad life. Exciting, huh?
No, I don't understand.
Oh, Edgar, don't you see the Vulcan Flash poster?
I am identical to him. The new Vulcan Flash. Next audition, I'm going straight to the top.
Thank you for convincing me, Liz. Edgar continued. I'll make it in the movies as an alien.
Yes, yes, yes. This is all very well and good. But ask me about what's-his-name Brown's jacket.
Oh, no. The jacket. Where is it?
Put away. I was afraid you'd drip on it when you drank the pigment.
He drank the pigment?
You think of everything.
And this is where you tell me I get to keep it.
You're right.
I suppose that's the least I can do for you, Liz.
I can do for you, Liz. Eh?
How did you know what I was going to say?
What I was going to say?
I had no idea. And now I'm telling you to go back to rehearsing, okay?
I'm on it.
He's in such a hurry. And I haven't even told him.
A new Vulcan Flash.
Is he talking to himself? I don't need any autographs. That's fine where it is.
I think I am. I don't know what that accomplished here, actually. Really certain what I accomplished. Let's see if, Dan the Jerk is interested in the jacket. Why is she walking like that? Oh, I can go talk to the robot. Ooh.
Hey, yo, short stuff.
I knew you'd come. Take me with you.
Where?
To the great beyond, to my final resting
place.
Aww,
it's a poor sad robot.
Peace.
No way. Never on the first date.
Are you not my Grim Reaper, the angel of death, the bearer of the scythe, the stealer of souls?
Oh, now I know who you're talking about. It's a guy with hiccups who's still at the party. Quite elderly. I'm Liz, and you?
Phil. My time has
poor
not
Phil.
Come. It never comes.
Have you seen Big Albert?
I have seen things you can't imagine. I've seen ivy grow higher on the wall. I've seen lightning bugs shining in the darkness near the door to the mansion. I've seen all this and much more. All of which will disappear in time. But
like
Big
teardrops
Albert,
in the rain.
Let's talk about you.
It's a Blade Runner reference, just to let you know. I have never seen you before. What do you
I've
do?
I've never seen you before. What do you do?
Pull petals off the daisy of existence. I'm dying. I'm not dying. I'm dying. I'm not dying. I'm dying.
What work do you do while you're pulling the petals
and
off the...
And what work do you do while you're pulling the petals off the daisy of existence?
Gardening. I plant, I water, I cut fence posts with the saw. I observe how everything decays in the relentless march of time.
What's behind this door?
My tool shed, my greenhouse, my veil of tears. Do you want to go in?
Never on the first date.
Sensible lady. If she is a little crazy. Why are you here doing nothing?
Why are you here doing nothing?
I'm not. I'm dragging myself toward the inevitable bitter end.
So Marvin from Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. What do you mean, dear?
What do you do here, apart from dragging yourself toward the inevitable bitter end?
Lots of drunkards on the loose. They step on the grass. Hollow men crushing lilies underfoot in the land of death.
I'm sorry, I'm not gonna get any good headlines out of you.
I think he's my new favorite character in this. Are you feeling sad?
Are you feeling sad?
Sadness is the only real name of that which you call life.
Yeah, we'll talk later.
If we don't expire first.
Oh my. Aw, poor robot. I can go pet the doggy.
You're awfully crabby, Tubby. I was going to pet him, but he blew it.
Oh, I can actually walk through the area. Okay.
I can't go in this way. Someone could see me like I saw Big Albert.
Oh. It'd be helpful if I actually figured out, like, actual ways to, like, control this game. Because, you know... Wait, no. Okay. I can go into
nope,
the theater.
It's closed and there's no one left.
Oh. Wow, wow, wow. R. Says me I can open the hood. I can.
I like it closed because then it's like it's not there.
Okay, so I can talk to Dan. The jerk. Remember, Dan's a jerk.
Ayo, Dan! So how are you doing?
Better than you, my dear.
You touched me in a highly restricted area. Can you confirm this?
You touched me on a highly restricted area. Do you confirm this?
You know it was unintentional. It was with the back of my hand, for God's sake. I was standing still in the hallway. It was you who stormed down the hall. You who bumped into me and... Really, it was you who molested my hand with your... restricted area.
Apologize.
I don't know how to pronounce those words. I trip over my tongue.
Like I just, this is meant to just walk down the way.
You are going to apologize to me.
You can't let go of it. Do you like it that much?
You will apologize to me sooner or later.
My money's on later.
If you apologize, we can change the subject.
I vote for the latter.
Okay, so...
When the boss finds out who did all the interviews, you're gonna be in hot water.
He won't find out. Liz Allaire's no stool pigeon. Or is she?
Sometimes I blurt out things without meaning to.
You wouldn't dare.
Try me. So, what exactly did you do wrong?
I met you.
You must have done something wrong for the boss to take you off your beloved sports section and put you on the society beat.
Did you have a thing going with the boss's wife?
Did you have a thing going with the boss's wife?
That witch? I'd sooner have a thing with you. With anybody.
Did you hit someone?
Did you hit someone?
A jab to the left. I can't remember. A jab to the right. He deserved it.
You wrote something that didn't follow the paper's editorial
line. You wrote something that didn't follow the paper's editorial line.
Always. I write what I feel like, however and whenever I want.
Actually, I could care less what you did.
Fascinating.
Well, why don't you help me get Fitz Randolph?
Why don't you help me get Fitz Randolph away from the hall?
Because I bet half my salary on the fight tonight, and in a little while they'll be announcing the winner.
That's no excuse. Come on, I only need you for 5 minutes.
It's a shame that I can't help you. A real shame.
You bet money on a fight. Tell me more.
Jim Bad Blood Dixon against Ron Hellman Pearl Boy. Small potatoes, at least compared to next Friday.
You missed the fight because they sent you here as punishment. Do you confirm that?
That's not the worst. Mr. Boss set it up so they won't let me into the stadiums, racetracks, and arenas. They turned the faucet off. Gosh, I can't miss Friday. Manny Hammerboy Brown against Rico the Italian Stallion Sandretti. I would do anything to be there.
The coat check guy is wearing Hammerboy's jacket.
Good for him. Can he get me tickets for the fight on Friday?
I don't know. Let's change the subject. I hope you freeze.
To your health.
Okay. But I think I can do something with the jacket.
Could there be anything in the pockets? Ah, look. How convenient.
Tickets.
Boxing. There must be someone who likes it.
I wonder who.
Dan, have you seen me eat paper?
Can't say I've had the pleasure.
Watch. I have here two pieces that say Rico, the Italian Stallion Sandretti versus Manny, Hammerboy Brown.
Give them to me.
Fitz Randolph, away from the hall. Now.
Hey, Willie.
Murray, my friend. You doing good?
Better than you.
When are we gonna get together, throw a few punches?
I'd like to throw back a drink. I see you're empty.
What a guy.
And that was how Liz convinced Dan to get Fitz Randolph away from the hall.
So I sort of did that out of order. But it worked. Ooh.
Dan's.
Not anymore. Finders keepers.
It's half full. It's Dan's. I'll give them to Dan, if he's good.
If he's really, really good. Okay. Anything else I can do?
I look good in this picture, no matter what my sisters say.
Yeah, don't listen to them. Wait, hold on.
None of this is worth the trouble.
What's in the trunk? Or, now that Dan, the jerk's not sitting on it anymore.
How strange. Being Dan's, I expected to find a trunk full of old, dirty, worthless junk. But apart from this empty oil can and a baseball bat, there's nothing.
Oh, I got the baseball bat.
Nope, there's only a baseball bat. I don't want that.
Okay.
Empty. Typical of Dan.
Okay. Oh, wait. Hold on. Go take a look at that again.
Empty. Typical of Dan.
Harry Hausen and Company. From the guy who did the special effects for Clash of the Titans. A great miniature special effects guy. Okay. Let's see. I'm going to the hall now. We'll find out, because now Fitz Randolph isn't there any longer.
Now I can.
Now I can. Oh, we got another robot.
Is he asleep? Good.
Sneak past sleepy robot. Why is the robot asleep? This guy has really creepy paintings.
Closed. Life is like a crocodile. Wait a minute. Aren't the offices of Fitz Randolph and his secretary connected?
He has a brilliant idea. Nope.
Even if they are.
Okay, so let's see.
He's out like a light.
Can't talk to him.
It could be another office, but I have no idea. It's a still photograph from the sinister caped light bulb. A huge hit for MKO. This stays here.
Really creepy.
Spencer McDundee. He's actually Australian, but for some reason he's good at playing Scottish ghosts.
What?
I have too many already. My sister, Queenie, the pretty one, is an artist, and she gave me all of them. They're in the attic. FitzRandolph's. Closed. Closed. Sparky, the Vulcanian sheep. Vulcan Flash's faithful pet.
What?
No, too heavy.
Okay, let's save. Before I go wake up the robot. There's your cape light bulb, Spencer McDundee, Stray. So I still need to figure out whatever this is.
Hey yo, short stuff.
Hey yo, nice night. Considering that at this time of year...
You open office doors, right?
Affirmative. Considering that at this time of year, it usually cools...
What's your name, sweetheart?
Jimmy Love. It usually cools down.
It's very single-minded for a robot. As you know, she is.
Comes late and all...
Look, for Jimmy, I'm not going to ask you to open FitzRandolph's office.
Only authorized subject, William A. FitzRandolph. Late and all at once.
But his secretary's yes. Okay, sweetheart?
Only authorized subject, Beverly Torrance. Hair blonde. Eyes blue. Bust 50. Waist 24. Hips 36. Negative identification.
Access denied.
Access denied? Liz said to herself, we'll just see about that.
Aren't you the charmer?
Integrated elevator conversation chip. We'll have to start dressing more warmly.
Informational topic unit. Doors. Who is Beverly Torrance?
Beverly Torrance, secretary, authorization, door 2. Although at this time of year, you know how it is. If you dress warmly, sunshine, and if not, you freeze to death.
Okay, so how do these go? First
door. Open the first door for me.
I have never opened it. It's not possible. Jammed. Maybe it's the humidity. A lot of humidity these last few winters.
Open the second door.
Only authorized subject, Beverly Torrance. Hair blonde, eyes blue. Bust 50, waist 24, hips 36. Negative identification.
Access denied.
Open the third door.
Access denied.
But I was in here just last month when I interviewed your boss.
It was a lovely morning, but it drizzled in the afternoon. The weather is crazy.
Informational topic unit closed.
Are you sleepy?
Power conservation mode. Low on oil. Isn't the autumn sun splendid?
It is to be believed, because it is absurd, Tertullian.
Disconcerting. I don't understand.
That is the path. I don't understand, but I believe.
I don't understand, but I don't understand.
Hey, time for bed, sweetheart.
I don't understand. Okay, let's see.
It's empty. Great idea. Pumpkin punch and a can of motor oil. Anyone care for some? The first motor oil made from pumpkin punch. Pumpkin punch, Jimmy?
I'd like to, but Mr. Fitz Randolph will fire me if he sees me drinking. He only lets us drink oil so that we don't rust.
He's in the ballroom. He won't see you.
No, no, no. I don't dare. He could show up at any moment, like a summer thunderstorm.
Don't worry. I'll figure out something else. But you'll have your punch. I bet you can't guess what's inside this oil can.
Can I kind of skip the step here?
Affirmative. Suddenly, everything is like cloudy. The weather is just crazy.
He's out like a light. Closed. Closed.
Okay, so now that I got him drunk, Jimmy Pumpkin Punch love. I wonder if I can fool him now drunk.
Hey yo, Jimmy.
Nice night.
Open the second door for me.
The authorized subject, Beverly Torrance. Her plan eyes blue. Bust 50. Waist 24. Hips 36. Positive identification. Access allowed.
It's over there. Nope, oh, nope, oh, that's the couch. Yep, boop, okay, nope, there you go. And, can you get the key in? Oh, nope. Yep. Okay, almost there. No. No. Yeah, I heard guys have this problem when they drink too much. That works.
And that was how, with the help of the pumpkin punch, Liz got Jimmy Love to open the door to the secretary's office.
Thanks, sweetheart. Fitz Randolph Mansion, Halloween night. My exclusive interview with Big Albert. Hey, you, Albert. Liz Allaire of the Quill.
Huh?
4 questions. 20. Can you tell me your motive for sneaking into the magnate Fitz Randolph's office? 12. What's that in your hand? 1. Are the rumors that say you're a kleptomaniac true, or did I just invent that to get under your skin a bit? 4. Are you listening?
Now, give this to the immaterial man. Hurry.
Poor Liz. For once, fortune seemed within reach, only to elude her. On the other hand, if she had managed to get into Fitz Randolph's office, she would only have solved the mystery surrounding Big Albert after reading that note.
Okay.
She's not altogether ugly.
Really?
She's fat and heavy. No.
Well, she's not that ugly, though.
Too many curves. Carrying a few extra pounds. I don't like her.
Fine.
Nice place to curl up with a book. Someone irresponsible like Dan Murray would sit down and...
There you go.
Sports stuff is so tiring.
Okay.
It's Eva Marte, the Dark Lady. She's evil, perverse, and bad as they come.
Depends on my type of gal.
It's like Mother, but without the designer clothing. Strange that Fitz Randolph has such an obsolete model. After all, he bankrolls the inventions of Professor Fly, who's designed more advanced phonographs than this. What if I put on some music to dance? On second thought, after they laughed at me at the party, I'm not really in the mood.
Aww.
Us skinny girls without so much up front are much more attractive. Dan Murray's reply, "You're still in your fantasy world, my dear." I don't want to be her friend. She's fat and heavy. No.
Let's see. Telephone. Over here. Window.
Garden, dock, and on the other side of the lake, the studios. It wouldn't do me any good.
Door. Can't look up, Eddie.
This leads to the hall. No, I can get out to the hallway from the other office.
Okay. Beverly's office.
The interviews on this tape are gonna help me write a great story. But nothing compared to the one I'll write if I discover what Big Albert is up to. Fitz Randolph could have gotten this from one of his movies. I could move it. I don't see what for. I haven't listened to the radio since my internship at JUNK in Los Angeles. You get sick of it.
JUNK. Junk. Los Angeles.
I don't need it for anything.
Bug.
Pencils.
Oh.
What luck! Not even chewed on. My co-workers tell me I eat pencils. Not true. I bring sandwiches from home.
Who do I? You have a pencil.
It has a hole where I could insert it, but it's not the same size.
Said.
There are only pencils, and I already have one.
Poor Jimmy.
His dinner must not have agreed with him.
He doesn't walk very fast. Hmm.
well, sweetheart. You can't deny it. You have seen Big Albert.
Why deny the obvious? Why try to avoid the unavoidable?
So melodramatic.
Do you have Big Albert's note?
No. I ran into the immaterial man in the hall, and I gave it to him. Everything meets its end, sooner or later.
Do you know what the note said?
Why bother if we're all going to die anyway?
Do you know which way Big Albert went?
Yes, he went out that I don't know. Why should I pay attention to anything if everything is superfluous?
Which way did the immaterial man go?
There's only one possible destination. Nothingness, non-existence, death.
Clearly, you don't know anything.
The only certainty in life is the tomb.
Me, I'm not going to expire. It just doesn't interest me.
Bad choice. If you do expire, fine, but... And if you don't?
Let's talk about you.
No.
I'm sorry, I'm not gonna get any good headlines out of you. And yeah, we'll talk later.
If we don't expire first.
Tabby the Third is in there with the notebook that Big Albert threw away after tearing out a sheet for Phil.
There we go. I need to figure out a way to lure the dog out.
If I want the notebook, I'll have to think of something. Because I can see that if I stick my hand in there, I'm gonna lose it.
What do we have?
Tabby the Third is in there with the notebook that Big Albert threw away after tearing out a sheet for Phil.
Now I need to figure out a way to lure the dog out. Maybe Phil has something?
Phil, sweetheart! Talk to me about happy things. You can do it.
No. Defective conversation ship. It worked properly for one day. Fleeting and fraudulent happiness.
Let's talk about you. What's behind this door?
My tool shed. My greenhouse. My veil of tears. Do you want to go in?
Never on the first date.
Disconcerting.
I'm sorry, I'm not gonna get any good headlines out of you. And yeah, we'll talk later.
If we don't expire first.
Okay, so I need to figure out a way to lure the dog out. Like this.
If I want the notebook, I'll have to think of something. Because I can see that if I stick my hand in there, I'm gonna lose it.
Nope, not that.
I didn't miss anything here.
Any ideas?
like to play with crocodiles. Nope, there's only a baseball bat. I don't want that.
Okay, so baseball bat's not the solution. There's something inside. Wonder, could I take something from the suit of armor?
Hey yo, short stuff! Cat got your language chip?
Negative!
Well, it's been a pleasure. See you later.
Negative!
There's anything here.
Hey, there's something on it. Hey, there's something on it. A crank handle.
It's a phonograph.
Archie McCandless gave me a rose once and said, "Care to dine with me?" I told him, "No, thank you. I've already had dinner. You eat it."
Mm-hmm.
I could pick some roses, but I'm full. This is good for getting into trouble for jumping on it.
Oh, please let me jump.
Nothing
on
in that interests me.
Really?
Should I take a seat? Nah.
But I think. Jar. It's not the jar. But I can go check out the phonograph now. Maybe the phonograph will unlock something I can unlock the dog with. Like a cascading of things. Nope, nope. Go into the office. There you go. Okay, go here. Inventory. There we go. Into you.
Wasn't this in the other office? It has an unusual mechanism that redecorates the adjoining office.
And listen to that music. Well,
Fitz Randolph is clever. One turn of the phonograph crank, and the table, part of the floor, and the wall turn, and this appears. Listen to what I'm telling you, Liz. The rose-colored bed. William A. Fitz Randolph's dirty laundry. A Liz Allaire exclusive. Forget it. The gossip rags don't interest me.
I was not expecting this.
An ice bucket, tongs, and a can of caviar.
Oh, can I take the tongs? Because then I won't get my hand ripped, but there's lingerie over there.
Expensive caviar. My sister, Anne-Marie, the smart one, uses it to make sandwiches.
Tongs.
There's nothing here that interests me.
I don't want the caviar.
This is where Fitz Randolph dictates his letters to his secretary, but only the long ones.
Is that what they're calling it now? Is that what the kids are calling it these days? Dictates his letters.
No way. Sleep here and you turn into Hannah Montana. Bachelorhood as Fitz Randolph understands it.
Well.
I don't want to listen to the radio. It's much too heavy for me to carry.
Yes. Now I wonder. to go back out to the dog with my caviar. See, that's what I need. Let me spend the time waiting for her to walk. One of the games I've played recently, never finished it, I have to get back to it at some point, is The Longest Journey, and another very old, very classic point-and-click adventure game. And one of the things about that there is just how long it takes to get the character to walk from point A to point B in order to do something. And if you go to like one point and you forgot to get something and have to walk all the way back, it just takes forever. Okay. Yeah. Let's see what. Let's look at the caviar.
Fitz Randolph and his secretary certainly know how to live it up.
Okay. That's caviar the doghouse. Don't really know what this will do, but I don't have any other options right now.
And the magic word for today is caviar.
Zip.
But the real magic would be if something was written on it.
I wonder how I could figure out what was written on that pad. Well, let's see, what else did I pick up? I picked up a pencil. Not a particularly difficult puzzle here. You, on to you.
Warehouse, ASAP.
Dun dun dun.
When she finally found
out very good handwriting
Albert's
for a guy with a zipper head.
Liz headed to Fitz Randolph's storeroom, located behind the mansion.
To the warehouse, then. Hopefully Big Albert and Immaterial Man are still there.
Immaterial Man.
I'll turn on my tape recorder.
I thought you only had like 5 minutes of recording left on that thing. Oh no!
Easy now.
Immaterial?
The people who did this will be back. Help me.
Count me in. What do I do? I'm your girl.
The important part is safe and sound now. We'll simply bury the rest.
Lights oh, up. There's the little robots that I used for my little character icon. And
at noon the following day, Dan was awakened by a ringing telephone. It was his boss. Liz and Dan hadn't shown up at the paper that day, and he was, how can I put it, pretty angry.
Worry. I won't tolerate another screw-up. I had to work late
tonight. You hear me, Mr. Murray? You know, you don't understand it. If the story about last night's award ceremony doesn't make the Sunday edition, you and Mr. Mayor are going to be in hot water.
Very, very hot water, he screamed down the phone. Reluctantly, Dan went back to Fitz Randolph's mansion. Edgar told him that Liz had been seen going into the storeroom, where she evidently was no longer. Finding out what
oh,
had
no.
happened to his beloved colleague was not going
beloved?
To be that easy.
Really?
Beloved. My foot.
That, there we go.
Los Angeles Stadium, Friday night. Manny Brown, Rico Sandretti.
He owes
That's
me those
what
tickets.
Counts.
Okay, so now I guess I'm the jerk. Oh, I kind of like playing. Kind of like playing Liz. She was like quirky and fun. Because the whole thing is, it's Quirky Tuesday. There's a poster. Let's go look at the poster.
Must be from some movie.
Oh, it's Vulcan Flesh.
Nice poster. And that's the end of it.
There's a ramp. What is... Okay, boiler. There's a belt. Clunk, clunk, clunk. Sofa.
I have one at home just like it. I always sleep on it, except when I have, company.
Newspapers?
Why, I've carried bundles like those, and even bigger ones. But, step by step, I've managed to get to where I am today.
Good for you, jerk.
I don't carry these things anymore. 5 second rest period, and I'm back on the court. This sports business is really tiring.
Really is a jerk. Now just look at the boiler.
That makes it downright cozy in here. Should I put out the fire? What for? That makes it downright cozy in here.
Let's go look
Doesn't
at the
belt. Doesn't this belong to that lunatic? Not that I pay attention to what she wears.
You should consider how well it will look on your bedroom floor. I'm sorry I said
Let's
that.
Let's hope I don't find more of her clothes lying around here. But, what's it to me?
Okay, what is he carrying?
It's 6 years old and it suits me to a T. To hell with fashion.
Can I put it on?
I don't want to burn this.
No, I want to put it on you.
Should I put out the fire? What for?
Okay, whatever. This.
The only one that was missing from my collection. I once pinched it from a store window and they caught me. I was 5 years old. At 12, I bought it with my first paycheck.
Well, that's good. Okay.
It's Liz's. I'd stake half my salary. It's Liz's. I'd stake half my salary. I don't want to burn this. I'm not bundling those up for delivery.
I think there's anything left in here. Okay, so what am I aiming for? Reveal what happened to Liz. Okay, so really what happened to Liz. Okay. Exit. Pansies.
MKO Pansies. Huh, it seems like Willy has some enemies. What am I going to do, erase it with my tongue? I'll pass.
These?
An 8-pack. Half my salary, they belong to Octopus Herring. Psychedelic.
Dude. Don't know. I don't. Can't. Hey. Okay. Okay. Bird. Oh, there is a bum. Sleeping. Jarn goat. El chuka cabras. Only one of them. Oh, L. Yeah.
He has the slowest hangovers in all of Mexico. That belongs to the chupacabras.
I take it. I can.
He never plays it in public.
But did I just take the poor guy's, like, guitar?
Charangote. This is a kit for making margaritas. But the salt
marvelous.
Shaker shaped like a cactus is kind of funny.
Okay.
I'm not surprised the chupacabra's in the condition he's in.
Well.
They were the chupacabras.
Oh. Well, the lemon juice I could probably use. Let's talk to you.
If I try and wake him up, he'll only fake being asleep. He owes me money. Oh, it's Robo Payne's workshop.
Snore, snore, snore.
What's this? One of the chupacabra's claws. And I thought they were natural. Nothing. That's not the way to get out. Every time I turn around, he dies on me.
Well, eating caviar probably does not help.
Heyo, Tabby! Attaboy, attaboy. No, I didn't bring you any caviar today, you glutton. Eya, go lay down. I haven't seen him since he was Tabby the Second. Could he have a genetic memory?
Okay, look.
They're in there cleaning up after the party, or something like that, and the robots aren't letting anyone in. Plus, Willy might be in there, and he'd invite me to stay for lunch or something, and that would bog me down.
Falcon Spirit. Oh, baseball bat.
My pal. It was in the trunk. I always carried in the car. It doesn't matter in which car. My editor lent it to me. It's his wife's. His is in the repair shop because... He lent it to me because mine has been in a slight accident. Some people never learn. And where am I going?
The Heart Attack and Vine to the the Honorable Establishment of Madame Lee. To know.
That's the ticket.
Okay. Wait. What's this down here? There's a corkscrew.
People lose all kinds of stuff at parties.
Take the corkscrew.
Well, what do you know? It's that idiot Mr. Death's soul extractor. Oh, yes. He was at the party, dying of hiccups, dancing without a partner. What a life.
Okay, When in doubt, hit it with a baseball bat.
Why not?
Rock on!
I know that this makes no sense, but this is my chance to use a bat.
These people are insane.
It wouldn't surprise me if the chupacabras, drunk as a skunk, had tried to do in the sad robot.
It's vicious.
Do I stick it back in? Nah, I'm keeping it. If that melancholy robot gets out, I'm going to get mad. This guy is the worst. No, the last time the robot in there caught me, I wished I was dead. I'd bet half my salary that when he wakes up, he won't even look for the Cherengote. If I try and wake him up, he'll only fake being asleep. He owes me money. I could use this to slip in, but if Willie sees me and he feels like talking, I'll be running against the clock. He only eats caviar.
Okay, so let's... go someplace? Should we go check out Madame Lee's establishment?
And where am I going?
It changed.
That's the ticket. And where am I going? Not until Michael Stone recovers from his injury. Sure, I could just go home and take a nap and give the tickets away. Not a chance. I wouldn't mind at all seeing Queenie, the lunatic's bodilicious sister, again, but I doubt she knows anything. And, well, I also don't want to worry the family. That's the ticket. The lunatic. And where am I going? Empty-handed? No.
The boss is already at the boiling point. Minerva Calixta's hostile fed's house.
Well, I don't want to see her again. She's always giving me expensive gifts.
Okay. I know where
that's the ticket.
Okay. Let's go back to the mansion. I'm obviously missing something here. I guess we should go, let's see. Can I use any of what I have here on anything else? Can I use you on
this? No.
Can I do?
I don't see what I'd gain by tying this. If I tie this, no. this one is soulless. There's no soul here to extract. There's no soul here to extract. This one is soulless. There's no soul here to extract. This? No. This? No. This? No. He owes me money, but I'm not going to torture him to get it.
Beat him with a baseball bat? I don't really want to do this.
He owes me money, but I'm not going to torture him to get it.
Hey, can I take his soul?
He has no soul to steal.
Really? Okay. Go back to the storeroom. Obviously, I'm missing something.
What am I going to do? Erase it with my tongue? I'll pass.
Oh wait, could I... Oh, this. Can I use this?
No way. I'd have to be a dame to know that lemon juice helps remove stains from paint. And I'm extremely macho.
Okay. Arr, Mr. Macho Man.
It's against Willy, but I'm not adding to it and or rubbing it off. It would end up too messy.
Okay. There's something else in here then.
Should I put out the fire? What for? I don't want to burn this. That wouldn't be very efficient. Better to use a document shredder. I don't want to burn this. I don't want to burn this. I wish.
Oh, that's cute. Absence of first pass there.
If I tie this... no. MKO pansies.
Maybe.
If he's got a soul, I don't want it. It's not time for pruning. They're in there cleaning up after the party, or something like that. and the robots aren't letting anyone in. Plus, Willie might be in there, and he'd invite me to stay for lunch or something, and that would bog me down.
Okay. I'm missing something. Wait, here. There we go.
Willy's Monster Factory. I don't see why people are so impressed with it.
There we go. I can go to the videos. And go to the guy, okay.
Pirate flicks. Can't stand them. Period. That's the one Willy uses when he has to go to festivals and other movie events.
Go to the Zeppelin. Okay.
Oh. Fascinating.
Sure.
Oh, if I really gave it my all, I could, but behind it has the mother of all knots.
Uh-huh, but could I do?
I don't know what I wanted for, but when you come from a neighborhood like mine, that's never the right question.
Hope is always useful to have. Okay. Blackboard.
No ferry service today. That's the one that goes to the studios. It's too heavy to pick up.
Can I spray paint the chalkboard?
This? No.
Okay. Go to the ship. Because it's about the only place I can go now. I mean, I could go to the studio, but apparently I can't take a ferry over there.
Closed. Hey, you in there? Ayo! And who wants to get in?
Okay, can we? The rope. Yeah. Okay.
The Chupacabra's fake claw doesn't have a chance against forged iron. I'm not getting on a pirate ship.
Okay, okay, okay. I'm going to wait for your very slow walk over there. Got some rope. Don't know what I'm going to do with it. Go to the studio.
I haven't overlooked anything around here. I haven't overlooked anything around here. Too far away.
Do with it now. Okay.
I don't see what I'd gain by tying this. If I tie this, no soul here to extract. If I tie this, no.
Yeah. There has to be something out at the... It has to be more than just me getting the rope out there. Okay, so maybe something to do with the ship.
No ferry service today. Could they have unlocked it while I was gone? And who wants to get in? Surely it's still locked. Surely it's still locked. If it were a smaller vehicle, I'd destroy it with the bat. But this is too much. This? No, I'm not painting this.
I'm a little puzzled.
Too far away. I wouldn't be able to navigate it. Half my salary says it's fake. If that melancholy robot gets out, I'm going to get mad. This guy is the worst. This might work for me to get in, but I pass. Where am I going? I haven't missed anything there. Who cares about movies? She just lost her husband. I have my standards. That's the ticket. I'm supposed to put this in the car? I'm supposed to put this in the car? On the door? Not in a million years. If I try and wake him up, he'll only fake being asleep. He owes me money. He owes me money. I'm keeping it. He owes me money, but I'm not going to torture him to get it. I'm not bundling those up for delivery. If I tie this... no. I don't want to burn this. I don't want to burn this.
Really quite long? Yeah.
It wouldn't surprise me if the chupacabras, drunk as a skunk, had tried to do in the sad robot. It must be 3 yards long. It's Liz's. I'd stake half my salary.
Stake half your salary on lots of things, don't you?
Nice touch, the cactus.
Is there anything more to do in here?
Ayo, Tabby!
He's cute.
Yes, I know, I smell like a party. Good nose. Aya, go lay down. They're in there cleaning up after the party, or something like that. And the robots aren't letting anyone in. Plus, Willy might be in there, and he'd invite me to stay for lunch or something, and that would bog me down.
Something to do with the ship. All I can think of is right.
I'll leave it there. No. Just in case, I'd take it off to get on the boat. Could they have unlocked it while I was gone? Ugh. And who wants to get in? The Chupacabra's fake claw doesn't have a chance against forged iron. Even if I could make a hole with it, it wouldn't accomplish anything but to sink it. I'll pass.
Number I've clicked 1,028 times. That's 25 objects. Covered 5.3 miles. Calories consumed. Zombie movie though. What? 75 romantic breakups. Zero reconciliation. Zebras hunted by lions and never Lions hunted by zebras. 13. Four-leaf clover sound by government employees with a 33% reduction in working hours. Gum stuck to the shoes of children wearing glasses with 0.25 diopters in the left eye and 0.5 diopters in the right eye. Recently discovered ancient civilizations whose technology amplifies zero. Sorry about that. Can I do something with the anchor chain? No. Nothing over here. What about this way? Back to the mansion. Yes. Studios.
Willie built all of this from nothing. That has merit. Well, okay, a pirate ship. Am I supposed to have something interesting to say on the subject?
Sorry.
I went inside once. You wouldn't believe it.
I am actually kind of lost right now. Yes. That, but I can't do anything with that.
He has the slowest hangovers in all of Mexico.
Okay. Can I use you on you? No. 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 A hat on you. No.
I don't want to break this. 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 If I tie this... No. If I tie this... No. If I tie this... No. He owes me money, but I'm not going to torture him to get it. Let him sleep.
Here with Tommy. Okay, so I feel like there is something else I need to do in that storeroom. But what? I don't know. This is where Liz disappeared, so...
Makes it downright cozy in here. I could open it, throw on some logs, take out the ashes. I don't think so. That makes it downright cozy in here. This is the life. The seats in stadium should be like this. Before I delivered papers, I was as boring as a Sunday without a football game. But working with the public turned yours truly into the charismatic, irresistible guy that we all know and love. I don't want to burn this. That wouldn't be very efficient. Better to use a document shredder. I don't want to break this. I don't want to burn this.
Anything else in here, is there?
Must be from some movie. Of course, have I ever told you how much I like monster movies?
I am running out of things to do.
What am I going to do? Erase it with my tongue? I'll pass. It's against Willie, but I'm not adding to it and or rubbing it off. It would end up too messy.
Mm-hmm.
No way. I'd have to be a dame to know that lemon juice helps remove stains from paint. And I'm extremely macho.
Okay, not that. Is it anything else?
He owes me money. I'm keeping it. This one is soulless. This one is soulless. If he's got a soul, I don't want it. Every time I turn around, he dies on me. They're in there cleaning up after the party, or something like that, and the robots aren't letting anyone in. Plus, Willie might be in there, and he'd invite me to stay for lunch or something, and that would bog me down.
This is going to be a very boring hour if I'm not able to figure out what to do next. Just, it's not... third. Now. Back to the mansion. Car.
And where am I going? No, he's at the mansion, and besides, I don't feel like talking to him. It's empty. At this hour, sweet Nancy Murray is serving breakfast at Charlie's coffee shop. Impossible. I couldn't even handle one of them today. That's the ticket. And where am I going? No, she'll be at work with Willie right now. Shouldn't mix work with, well, the rest of it.
The rest of it.
Empty-handed? No. The boss is already at the boiling point. It's been a while since I've seen Dirty Harvey, my first coach. But not today. I'll see him and we'll relive our old times in the ring some other day. That's the ticket.
Having to do this here, but I think I'm gonna have to look up some assistance because I am really lost. Just learned that double clicking on an exit arrow skips the walk into the next screen. That should speed up things a bit. Did get on with that. Okay. Okay. Apparently, I am supposed to use Tubby as a scent dog with Liz's belt. That's the one thing I never actually tried. Okay, Tubby, let's go find Liz.
Heyo, Tubby!
I may have gotten there at some point when I was gonna get to the point of just
Ayo, buddy.
Literally every single choice.
I've got a job for you.
He's really cute. He's like, oh, you know what he is? Hi! He's like Audrey 2 from Little Shop of Horrors. Little Shop of Horrors.
That's a long way down.
Okay. I hate that I had to go look up a walkthrough to get that.
Yeah. If she's in there, it's up to me to get her out.
Okay.
According to Tubby, Liz is down there.
Thanks, Tubby.
It's too far. How would I get back up?
I wonder. I have that solved this time.
Will this hold if I tie it?
Quarter. She has refrigerators on the brain. 2012. 2-4.
Now that he knew what had happened to Liz, Dan would only be able to find her by going after Big Albert. The sarcophagus, said Edgar. They took it to the Temple of Eternal Illusion. Now we're really in trouble, replied Dan. The Temple of Eternal Illusion. Headquarters of the famous sorceress known as High Priestess Chroma.
Hello.
It was completely impenetrable. Whoever entered was observed and analyzed by a scanner, which detected any sign of cerebral activity. And once inside, it was filled with deadly traps out of which no one had ever escaped.
Oh, it's like the knife that I was going after in the Sherlock Holmes game.
Increasingly difficult, but Dan had come too far. Plus, his feelings for Liz were becoming more intense all the time.
No, they're not.
That ninny. Thanks to her, I'm going to be on the ropes again. If she's lost those tickets.
Go, Flash Falcon. Kajdanovsky. Ooh, there's a leaf.
Tubby must have dropped this. These pets expire so quickly nowadays.
Eat the leaf. Yay.
Poor Tubby. Every winter, the same story.
Aw, poor Tubby.
His first name is, Elmer. Edward. Ethan. Kajdanovsky.
Edgar. Let's talk to him, though. Edwin?
Ayo, Kajdanovsky.
Back, you bloody earthling, or I'll vaporize you with my hypergalactic laser!
Are you stupid or what?
Dude, you're a jerk.
What a guy. But don't call me by my last name. I'm Edgar to my friends.
Fascinating.
Anyway, have you found out anything about our mutual friend?
Mutual? You're mistaken there. But tell me.
Why are you dressed like an idiot? Dan, why are you a jerk?
Why are you dressed like an idiot?
I'm the new Vulcan Flash!
Good for you. And who is this idiot?
don't pretend. Everyone knows who Vulcan Flash is.
I am not everyone.
Well, except for an Amundsen. There, he's called Vidiges Jimenez. They censored the original name. Because if you substitute an H for the V, a J for the U, an O for the F, an M for the C, and you say it backwards, you get a really bad word.
Okay, we're just moving on with this conversation.
So, who convinced you to dress like an idiot?
You'll never guess. Our friend Liz.
Can I go play with Liz again? She's better than this jerk. I love the graffiti.
Well,
you're
at least
a jerk.
If Randolph doesn't. That's why my job is to clean it off.
Is Willie around?
He was at the mansion, but he asked them to get the Zeppelin ready. Maybe he's already there.
MKO Pansies. Here's that half my salary thing again.
MKO Pansies, what's that about?
A new direction for MKO. Fitz Randolph wants to get out of the horror business and dedicate himself to family films.
Aww. As long as
family films don't interest me, but go on.
Apparently, it's not about sports.
Romantic
comedies, you're not interested.
Children's films, even musicals.
I apologize for the yawning.
I'm still not interested in family films. Go on.
The problem is that not all of the monster actors are in favor of the change, and they're trying to boycott it. In part, I understand them. You build a career scaring people, and then they make you play the Cookie Monster.
Oh, cookies. Can I eat this? Let's find out. Nom, 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 nom.
Half my salary says the graffiti.
For sure. Do you know that in Amundsen, it's forbidden to put octopi in your socks, punishable by spanking?
Fascinating. This is starting to bore me. Let's move on.
Yep.
So, they've taken the sarcophagus away. Where did they take the sarcophagus?
To the Temple of Eternal
Didn't
Illusion.
We already go over this?
And what's this about the temple being impenetrable?
It is. No one's ever gotten in, except for Kromha's performances on Tuesdays.
And the second Thursdays of the month.
The people in the audience don't even know how they got in. They're outside waiting in line. And then suddenly, bam! They're inside, comfortably ensconced in their assigned seats.
What day is it today?
Saturday.
Oh. What is the temple in reality?
A temple.
Well, you're really asking for it.
What a guy. It's a pyramid that Kromha had brought from Egypt, block by block.
Enough about the temple for the moment.
This game definitely has a level of absurdity that's fun to play around with. Shh. I'm talking to you.
Hey, Space Cadet!
Back, Earthling!
Mm-mm. So, they've taken the sarcophagus away.
Ah.
What's a sarcophagus doing in a storeroom?
The High Priestess Kromha used it in an illusion she performed during the ceremony.
The High Priestess Kromha, the one with the two...
The very one.
What a guess. He's got enough there for four.
It doesn't surprise me that she does illusions. No one looks at her hands.
How long ago
did they take it?
About a half hour before you got here. I had to call them to come pick it up.
Where did they take the sarcophagus?
To the Temple of Eternal Illusion.
Okay. Enough about the temple.
Enough about... What is the temple?
A temple.
You're... And what's the...
It is the best... Bear.
Okay.
Hey, Earl. Hey, Dan.
Okay, so...
It's going to take him a while.
I don't envy him.
Okay, so we made some progress with the benefit of okay. So we need to figure out what this whole block is, which then goes into these blocks. Okay. Back this way. Okay, they're snoring. Okay, so now we can go
at
back.
At last, they opened it.
There we go.
I'll help you construct it, erect it, put together a new weapon.
Scientifically impossible.
I'm going to die anyway.
Morally reprehensible.
But what about poetry, beauty, purity, and artistry?
Economically inviolable.
Well, I'll get into one of these.
I won't discuss it. You won't fit, poet.
You won't fit. You won't fit. You won't fit.
Whoa,
take it easy.
Oh. Aw. He's apparently upset about something. Must be caring.
Heyo, Dan Murray.
You can play with a magnifying glass. That might be useful.
Guilty as charged. And you have pint.
What a guy. Professor Fly, at your service.
Good. And that idiot outside, what's with him?
The poet? Oh, he wants me to build him a custom-made teletransporter booth.
Uh-huh.
What?
Oh, a neophyte. Let me show you.
This is how he became Professor Fly. I've seen that movie.
Two booths. The foolhardy volunteer gets into one of them.
The poor duck.
Yes.
Aww. He's cool, duck.
And instantly appears in the other.
Does the duck get frequent flyer miles?
Interesting.
Dan understood the great potential in that magnificent invention for furthering his plans. And he made it known to Professor Fly.
Not bad. Have you got a volunteer half pint? Apart from the rubber ducky?
Oh, I wish. The poet wanted to, but I won't even discuss it.
Well, now you have one. Let's get on with it.
Oh, that would be morally reprehensible.
You just say this.
The porter is still in the Zeta stage.
Zeta
it's randomly
stage.
Lethal. Lethally random. Especially for the liver. It is for that reason that I only accept volunteers that meet three requirements.
One, said Fly, they have to be completely expendable to society. Two, their life expectancy must be less than 1 year, 2 months, 9 days, and 37 minutes. Three, they must pass my psychological test for the purpose of accrediting psychic devastation to the utmost degree.
What do I have to do for you to consider me socially expendable?
I won't discuss it. You work at the Quill. You're a sports journalism genius.
What's with the worm down there in the corner? Psychic devastation test. That sounds like fun.
What do you want to bet I beat the record?
Let's get to work. They're just four little ink blots. What do you see there?
Indifference. A bunch of depressing things not worth mentioning. A bunch of depressing things not worth mentioning. A pretty little flower. Yeah, let's go with the flower.
A pretty little flower.
This is not psychic devastation or anything like it. I'm sorry, try again when you're really dissipated.
Okay, and...
My life expectancy is almost nil.
Are you sure? That's experimentally demonstrable. Demonstrably experimental. Do you see that machine in the corner?
Better than you. I don't have bug eyes.
What a guy. But it's true. I can't see all that well because I lost my glasses yesterday.
Yeah.
So the machine is called
Edgar has
a life-o-meter.
Sorry about that.
It uses
the breath to determine the subject's total remaining life expectancy down to the minute.
How much time until he kicks the bucket, right?
Definitively positive. Positively definitive.
Okay.
What do you have to say about the poet? Is he stupid or just pretending to
Dude,
be?
Dude, you're still
a
jerk.
Well, the poet of pain is peculiar.
Peculiar?
Yes, peculiar.
Peculiar in what way?
In a peculiar way.
I get it. Very peculiar?
Between somewhat.
We're not getting anywhere with this conversation.
Peculiar, period?
What they call peculiar.
Like this peculiar attempt at a
conversation. How far can I take this?
It is a somewhat peculiar conversation, yes.
Is this peculiar conversation getting us anywhere?
No, but if you keep insisting, I'm going to start thinking that you're peculiar.
Peculiar? Me?
We're just going to see how far this goes.
Me? Peculiar?
You! Peculiar!
Me? But wasn't it the poet who was peculiar?
Well, the poet of pain is peculiar.
I don't think we're going to do that again.
Why can't he be your volunteer?
Unfortunately, that's scientifically impossible, since my teletransporter booth won't accommodate him. Economically inviable, the cost of building a booth his size would be astronomical. And morally reprehensible, as we are talking about one of the greatest literary figures of our time.
That's his name? Poet?
The Poet of Pain. He's already published 3 volumes of poetry, all with the same theme. Unfortunately, he's beginning to repeat himself.
Has he always gone in for verse? Hmm?
He used to be a stunt double in the movies. He has a very high tolerance to pain, so he would do anything. He used to specialize in the most physically punishing stunts. The best part is that afterwards, he would tell his colleagues all about the pain he'd experienced. He did it so poetically that someone said to him, "You have got to write this down, man."
Why does he want to be your volunteer?
My teletransporter booths are in the Zeta stage. They're very dangerous for the volunteer, and the poet sees an enticingly new form of pain in it, and...
Enticingly new.
Poets, enough nonsense. Back up to the ceiling, Half Pint.
What a guy.
Okay.
Almost as orderly as my desk at the Quill.
Almost as orderly as my desk at work, too.
None of this interests me.
Console.
Very funny. When the test's over, I'll smash it. No, for the test, I'll call Half Pint, and that's it. I don't know what it is. I don't want to know.
It looks like a little lizard in a tank.
Oh, I'm not touching that.
Let's see. What else do we have? Look at the hands. The little worm thing I was talking about.
Strange.
Doctor Strange.
Let's see. How many decades do I have left?
Yes. 5 months, 6 days, 12 hours, 9.
5 years, 6 months, 12 days, 9 hours. Revolting machine.
Okay, so we need to somehow...
And the worst thing is that I'd have to have less than 2 years left to live for Fly to accept me to be his volunteer.
So, what do I have that I know is going to be dying soon? Let us... do this.
Tabby dies every autumn and is reborn every spring. I've got nothing to lose.
Poor Tubby.
I know. Pretty impressive, huh?
19 days left to live. Poor guy.
That's what I call a minimum life expectancy, said Fly.
Calm down. As long as I make it to the fight on Friday, everything's fine.
What a guy.
Okay.
No, for the test, I'll call Half Pint, and that's it. The farther you are from him, the less ugly he seems.
I'm coming!
Okay, let's see if we can do this test.
Everything okay?
Test time.
Test time.
They're just four little ink blots.
Basically, we just have to make something as psychically devastating as possible. A bunch of depressing things.
Not worth mentioning.
This is not psychic devastation or anything like it. I'm sorry, try again when you're really
I really need to channel Phil.
My talent as a writer has run out of gas. I'm socially expendable now.
I'm sorry to be so contemptibly frank, but this is frankly contemptible. If your boss can't get along without you, it's because you've still got a lot to give. I won't discuss it.
Who cares about the three requirements? I'll be your volunteer.
Highly inappropriate. On what basis?
I can be your volunteer or your worst nightmare. You decide.
What a guy.
I'm a walking case of psychic devastation. I'm ready to throw in the towel.
That is psychologically measurable, the test.
I'm a sucker.
Dan Murray, the great Dan Murray? No.
Yes, Half Pint. You got me. I'll meet your three requirements. I'm a cocky son of a gun, but when I look in the mirror, I don't recognize myself.
I even scare myself.
Socially, I am the most, but when I see my mother and she asks me if I'm happy, I have to lie to her.
And I'm supposed to believe that? That won't fly with me.
With bubbling, with that tank with the lizard in it, is driving me nuts.
I've been with hundreds of women.
All over town.
I haven't loved any of them, and none of them have loved me.
And how do you think that makes
with
me
the hands
feel
all
with
over
these
everything.
Looks of mine?
Wait, is that a dragon up there? It is.
Everyone says hello to me on the street, but no one asks me how I am.
What for? You look fine to me. I won't discuss it.
Well, there's no convincing you. You got me. I'll meet your three requirements. Get back up there. You look better up there.
Okay, now I need to come down again.
Everything okay?
Okay.
Test time.
They're just four little
I'll figure this one out at some point.
What do you see there?
A fire in the Freak Stadium 3 years ago.
This is not psychic devastation or anything like it.
Okay.
Get back up there. You look better up there.
What a guy!
Let's see. Go talk to the poet, and maybe he'll give me some insight on how to be psychic devastating.
Listen up. I'm going to be the volunteer for... What? You're burning your own hand?
Pain inspires me. A new verse. A fresh new verse. An infernal sun scorches my skin. Implacable. Two-faced. Cruel.
Want me to break your face? It's no trouble.
No. Very trite. It doesn't inspire me.
You should go hang out with Phil.
New pains for new verses. Give me novelty.
Good. You stay right here. You're going to go nuts over this.
Okay, do I have anything I can do? Oh, what about this?
I've got something that might inspire you.
Novelty. Give me novelty.
Lemon and salt.
Ew. Random cat.
So, a new verse?
I'm inspired. It's coming to me. It's on the tip of my tongue.
Well, share it.
Like a ravenous zombie, my right eye devours my brain.
What a verse, my friend. What a verse.
Thank you, friend.
Ah, that makes things a lot faster.
No. Last time the robot in there caught me, I wished I was dead.
But he's like the example of psychic devastation. Oh well, we'll continue on. Oh god, it's so much nicer that I figured out how to fly.
He's not even
Mr. Fly.
Everything okay?
Get back up there. You look better up there.
Can't see what I'm doing. Ah. Can I maybe do something like this?
I'll pass.
Okay.
Either it has a soul or it doesn't. I don't know, and I don't care.
Wait a second. What about using you?
I've got something that might inspire you.
Novelty. Give me novelty.
Come on, extract your soul. See if that hurts. So, a new verse?
I'm inspired. It's coming to me. It's on the tip of my tongue.
Well, share it.
And you think that doesn't hurt? I've lost a molar.
What a verse, my friend. What a verse.
Thank you, friend.
Okay, what did I end up there?
Very funny. When the test's over, I'll smash it.
Okay. Let me figure out this test. What am I getting with these verses? I'm so confused with some of these things.
Test time.
They're just four little ink blots. What do you see there?
Aha, here we go. Okay.
A hellish sun scorches my skin.
I got my three. Oh, I need four.
Cruel.
Great. Don't you hit him with a baseball bat?
Come on, you've only got three left. What do you see there?
A ravenous zombie, my right eye devouring my brain.
Great answer. You still have two left. What do you see there?
How is that not supposed to hurt? I've lost a mole.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
Great answer. Let's see how you do on the last one. What do you see there?
Boredom.
This is not psychic devastation or anything like it. I'm sorry, try again when you're really dissipated.
Okay.
Back up to the ceiling, half pint.
Okay, so we got there. Okay, so what else do I have left? Can I paint him? Oh, wait. This.
I've got something that might inspire you.
There we go.
Novelty. Novelty.
I need to get a fourth verse.
Give me novelty.
A razor. You grab it and you slice here, there, freeform, wherever you want to.
I never repeat myself. I never repeat myself. I never repeat, 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 I repeat.
You're not saying you've already cut yourself with a razor here and there, freeform, wherever you feel like it?
Novelty. Novelty. Give me novelty.
Shoot.
Okay, so obviously that's on it. What about the...
I've got something that might inspire you.
Novelty, novelty, give me novelty.
Spray cans. You stick one in...
Herring, herring, octopus herring.
Yes, they're his. Do you have a problem with that?
Plenty. I despise him. I ignore him. I spit on him. I don't want to. I don't want to. I don't want to.
Come on, forget about it. It takes all kinds.
Okay, so that's it. Paper cut. Okay. Okay, how about I just smack him with a baseball bat?
I've got something that might inspire you.
Novelty, novelty. Give me novelty.
A bat. I'm going to break your face and...
I never repeat myself. I never repeat myself. I never repeat, 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 I repeat.
You don't say. You've already had your face bashed in with a bat.
Novelty, novelty. Give me novelty.
Shoot.
What else do we have left? Guitar case. Okay. The belt.
I'll leave it there. Ayo, poet.
Poet, poet, poet.
Okay.
My words are enough to cause you pain.
Words too hurt, hurt, hurt. Interesting concept.
You're peculiar.
That's what they say, they say.
You don't understand. I mean, peculiar in a very bad way.
Peculiarity is not a bad thing. Peculiar is peculiar.
Yeah, yeah, but I'm saying it in a slightly peculiar way.
Peculiar?
Peculiar.
Who is peculiar?
You are peculiar.
That's what they say, they say.
Okay, we're just going around on the show.
Forget it. It's not worth insulting you, you mental midget. Hey-ya.
Hey-ya, hey-ya, hey-ya.
Hey-o, poet.
Give me novelty.
My words are enough to cause you pain.
Figure something out here.
As far as poets go, you're the worst.
Detrimental, aggravating, unmotivating, ineffectual.
Okay, I think we're going to go on the peculiar thing. We're going to see how long this goes on for.
They say.
You don't understand. I mean, peculiar in a very bad way.
Peculiarity is not a bad thing. Peculiar is peculiar.
Yeah, but I'm saying it in a slightly peculiar way.
Peculiar?
Peculiar.
Who is peculiar?
You are peculiar.
That's what they say.
You don't understand. I mean, peculiar in a very bad way.
Peculiarity is not a bad thing. Peculiar is peculiar.
When you were born, the doctor probably slapped your mother.
What a guy. What a guy. I've heard it's been said that she fled when she saw me.
Yeah, but I'm saying it in a slightly peculiar way.
Peculiar?
Peculiar.
Who is?
You.
That's what.
You don't know.
Pec.
Yeah.
Pec.
Peculiar.
Who?
You.
Pec.
You don't.
Peculiar.
Forget it. Are you sh-
Pec.
Risk.
What?
One that you think up here and now.
I have no inspiration. Give me novelty.
Something from one of your earlier books.
I don't repeat myself. I repeat.
I've changed my... Aya.
Aya.
Fast. And family. I'm still. This. Aya, Edric.
Aya.
I don't want to break this. The verses he tosses off reek of psychic devastation. Ayo! I'm going to do a cultural interview with you. My thing is sports, but I'm going to try this. Your biggest rival is your lack of inspiration. Do you think you'll defeat it?
There's no such thing as an insignificant rival, but I'm very motivated.
Disappointed that Fly didn't select you as a volunteer?
It's his team. He's the master, and he knows better than anyone how to handle it, lead it, shape it, assemble it.
Do you feel that you enjoy the support of the public?
Public.
So now we need to get another verse out of him.
Oh, one.
End of interview. Relax. My word. You smell.
So.
Forget it.
Okay, so let's go back and do Mr. Fly's poet that I can hurt him. Words.
Everything okay?
What do you have to say about the poet? Is he stupid?
Well. Yes.
Peculiar.
In between.
Peculiar.
It is.
Is this?
No.
Peculiar.
Peculiar.
Me.
You.
Me.
Well. Yeah.
Has he?
He had the best. He did it so poetic.
Why did
my tongue? There.
Test time.
Let's see how you do on the last one. What do you see there?
A sweet.
This is. I'm sorry.
Get back up. I don't plan on drinking from any of these bottles. I'm suffering from post-party abstinence syndrome. Almost as orderly as my desk at the Quill. No, for the test, I'll call half pint, and that's it. Oh, I'm not touching that. Oh, I'm not touching that. If I break it, this comes out. I pass. If I break it, this comes out. I pass. The farther you are from him, the less ugly he seems. I'm not trying to open it. Not much to see. Very funny. When the test's over, I'll smash it. I still have to pass the test, but after that, it's home run derby. Nice contraption. You shouldn't leave these things all over the floor.
Murray, careful walking there. Don't step on my camera.
I'm on top of everything. It's flies. How kind of him. Do I look like a freaky photographer? I don't plan on leaving that there. Ayo, poet. My word. Your
poet guy.
Half my
what wardrobe?
You.
That's what.
You
peck.
Yeah.
Peck.
Peck.
Poet.
You
peck.
You don't
peck.
Yeah.
Peck.
Peck.
Poet.
You
peck. Peck. Poet.
You don't understand. I
back you.
Forget it.
Okay, so that's apparently not the way to go. I don't have anything left to do. give him a paper cut. Okay.
I'm not painting this. No, he doesn't want them. No, he's already felt that pain and he needs something new. No, he's a- If I try and wake him up, if that melancholy robot gets out, I'm going to get mad. This guy is the worst. Heyo, Tabby! Thanks for the help back there, buddy. Eya, go lay down.
I'm missing something again. I hate doing that, but it's probably something simple. Oh, okay. Something that I never would have thought of. And I hate the fact that it's taken me this long to kind of... that I had to go look it up again. What just happened? I clicked out of the game. I am sorry. It's getting late. I have about 10 minutes left to go, and then we're gonna call it a night tonight. But yeah, let's at least pass this test. Okay. Blackboard, meet Chook Macabre's claws.
He's going to go nuts over this.
I love the animations of this game.
So, a new verse?
I'm inspired. It's coming to me. It's on the tip of my tongue.
Well, share it.
My ear, by a thousand bees.
There's the bees with the honeycomb.
Mortally wounded, bursts joyfully.
What a verse, my friend. What a verse.
Thank you, friend.
There we go. Let's go here. And let's to fly.
Everything okay?
Test time.
Let's see how you do on the last one. What do you see there?
My eardrum by a thousand bees,
mortally wounded, buzzing, thunderously ruptures.
Great answer, and congratulations!
Said Fly. You're so absolutely morally dissipated that you pass the test, but don't go overboard. I could still fail you.
Okay, so now I need to figure out what I need to do.
Get back up there.
Become a moral failure. Oh, can I smash the machine now?
Pass the test. Who needs the machine?
But I smashed the camera.
I don't want to break this. Do I look like an entomologist?
Okay, let's see. Oh, wait a second. Oh, okay.
If I break it, this comes out. I pass.
Bye. I think
everything okay?
I don't get anything at this point now. I think I'm gonna quit.
This floating laboratory must cost a fortune. Who bankrolls all this?
Can't you guess? Fitz Randolph. He finances all of my experiments. It's a good thing people like him exist.
Okay.
My talent as a writer has run out of gas. I'm socially expendable now.
I'm so... If your boss can't get...
Who cares?
Pilot.
I can be... I'm a...
Dad.
Yeah. Well, there's... You... Back up to the...
Okay.
What a guy.
So I think I am gonna probably...
Pass the test. Who needs the machine?
I am probably gonna leave this here right now. As I have to figure out what the next thing to do is.
I don't plan on drinking from any of these bottles. I'm suffering from post-party abstinence syndrome. I don't plan on leaving that there. I don't want... I don't plan on leaving that there. I'd grab it, but I'm too busy being sarcastic. I'll pass.
Yeah, I think at this point, I need to call it a night. I will figure out how to become socially or morally reprehensible next time. So as a reminder, this will be my last stream this week. Because I won't be available Friday or Sunday, I'll be playing again next Tuesday night, and for next Quirky Tuesday, I plan to play, I'm going to find a bunch of Game Jam games that were made at the International Game Jam this coming weekend. So hopefully I'll find a bunch of good stuff to play. They're not going to be long, so there'll be a whole ton that I'll play through the 3 hours. But yeah, this will be saved and uploaded to YouTube, like I normally do, and we will continue on. So thank you if you were watching. If you're watching this on YouTube, thank you for watching that there. Please leave a comment. And I will see you next Tuesday. Thank you.